Dedicated to preserving the legacy of Keali'i Pauahi. Long Distance USA, a Sprint company in support of the youth of today. Matson Navigation, committed to serving Hawaii best. And Grace Pacific Corporation, paving the way since 1921.
Aloha and welcome to the 72nd Annual Kamehameha School Song Contest. I'm Alicia Dow, Director of Communications for the Kamehameha Schools Bishop Estate, and with me tonight is the Director of Admissions, Wayne Chang.
Aloha, everyone. Welcome to what is sure to be a night of beautiful Hawaiian music.
As just about everyone in Hawaii must know by now, the annual song contest is one of the great traditions in Hawaii. Since that first contest at the School for Boys was held on the steps of the Bishop Museum, the event has grown to fill the Blaisdell Arena.
The 1,800 students of the high school division have been practicing for the past 6 weeks in preparation for tonight's contest, and their excitement fills the air. After one last rehearsal moments ago in the exhibition hall, the classes are taking their seats.
The song contest has become an important event on the cultural calendar of Hawaii. It's world famous. It is the only school-wide musical competition of its kind.
And an event of this size requires a lot of dedication on the part of the students, staff, and professionals who work to make it all happen.
Joining us now is Kamehameha School's Hawaiian language teacher, Robin Makua, with a look at the preparations for this song contest. Robin?
Aloha. With over 1,800 participants, the song contest is probably the largest musical affair in Hawaii. That's a lot of people in front of the cameras, and it requires the contribution of many people behind the scenes as well. The setup of the Blaisdell Arena starts days in advance of the contest. Lighting, audio, and video all are important elements of the program. The students make last-minute adjustments to the seating charts, placing their best singers where they can inspire the others. The students also create signs, urging each other to do their best. Back in the truck, the TV2 crew is getting ready, preparing graphics, and getting their video switcher ready for the big event. This is where the whole show comes together. Back on the arena floor, there are six cameras checking their shots. Way up high, the follow spots and lighting riggers make final adjustments. We even have spotlight operators suspended from the lighting truss. They'll be sitting above us throughout the performance. The student speakers have their chance to practice. Then, the ho'ike musicians take their turn. It's hard work, but it's a tradition that everyone is proud to be a part of.
Thank you, Robin. We'll be hearing more from Robin in our song contest prologue, and in just a few minutes we'll see just how all of that hard work and creativity pays off, enhancing the theme of this year's song contest.
Elisa, each year the students and staff pick a theme for the song contest, and this year's theme is Kalei, the lei.
The lei holds so much meaning in Hawaiian culture. It is an emblem of affection and a symbol of aloha, but it has even more significance in the poetic sense.
On a rocky beach at Kahakulua on Maui, a crippled woman danced and sang before the crashing waves. By chance, the goddess Hi'iaka Ikapole Opele happened by. Hi'iaka was touched by the sight of this woman, and on impulse, she plucked the segment of her leihala and tossed it to the dancer. The crippled woman breathed in the rich fragrance of the hala, and in her gratefulness, began to sing.
Ke lei mai lao ka ula I ke kai e. Ke mala mala ma on I hau amali e. Amali e pa
kai nua. Today, this melody is often used when hula dancers adorn themselves. As they fasten their lei, a chant of praise is given for Hi'iaka I Kapole Opele.
No kalua no ikilawea.
The theme this year for Kalei is about the beauty of all different types of leis, starting with flowers and feathers, but Hawaiian people might think even deeper about what a lei means. For them, a lei could mean a person, a special person, especially a little child. When a child holds his or her hands around your neck, they form a lei around your neck. When you caress your child in your arms, the child forms a lei around your body. So this special child then is called your lei. Some people call the entire family as being blossoms in a lei. So lei has so many special meanings.
Garlands of natural materials, flowers, feathers, shells, and fruits are found throughout the Pacific. It is believed that the custom of lei wearing was brought here by early Polynesian migrations.
They also frequently wear on the head a kind of ornament of a finger's thickness or more, covered with red and yellow feathers, curiously varied and tied behind. And on the arm, above the elbow, a kind of broad shellwork, grounded upon network.
Since those traditional times, the lei has been used to commemorate significant events, both formal and casual, historical and personal.
The Hawaiians believe that the spirits were everywhere and should always be accounted for every waking moment of the day. And regardless of what kind of activity, the honor and respect should be paid to the Akua. And if they went up into the mountain, for example, to collect the materials that they need to make the floral leis, they would be very mindful of conducting the rituals necessary, including things such as the prayer.
A lei could symbolize love or be an offering to the gods. Descriptions were often woven into the poetry of ancient chants. Lei were worn by ali'i to signify their rank, and lei were given to chiefs as a gesture of aloha and respect.
The appearance of Lahaina from the anchorage is singularly romantic and beautiful. A young man sent by the governor with a canoe was to be our guide. He walked before us as we entered his village. The old people from the houses welcomed him as he passed along, and numbers of the young men and women came out to meet him, salute him, and wept for joy at his arrival. Some took off his hat and crowned him with a garland of flowers. Others hung round his neck wreaths of a sweet-scented plant or necklaces composed of the nut of the fragrant pandanus. Multitudes of young people and children walked with him through the village, chanting his name, the names of his parents, the place and circumstances of his birth, and the most remarkable events in the history of his family in a lively song, which he informed us was composed at his birth.
Some types of permanent lei were associated with ali'i and were symbolic of their right to rule.
During his travels, the high chief, Liloa, took as his woman the beautiful Akahi Akuliana. When it was time for Liloa to return to his home at Waipio, Akahi Akuliana was with child. Liloa left instructions that if it was a boy child, he was to be named Umi and be given the chief's lei niho, palawa, his loincloth, and his war club. Years later, the young son went to his father at Waipio. Wearing his niho palawa, his loincloth, and the war club at his side, Liloa recognized Umi as his son and declared him the next high chief of Hamakua.
In that manner did the Lei Nihopalawa bind one generation to the next and represent a chief's right to rule.
The tongue shape represents the mana that is that speaks to the people and represents the mana of the gods, and the chiefs therefore are the spokesperson of the gods and the conduit from which the mana of the gods comes out and is spoken and shared with the people.
Ka'ahumanu was the favorite wife of Kamehameha Ekahi, Hawaii's last traditional ali'i. Her pendant is carved from a single whale's tooth held by braids of human hair. Lei Nihopalawa were worn only by ali'i and were kept within families for generations.
The family, of course, their rituals would also entail respect and honor of the gods and to accumulate the mana that could be received from the gods.
But after the death of Kamehameha Ekahi and the end of the traditional kapu system, the use of Lei Nihopalawa declined. The jewelry and adornments of the Westerners, Nā Poʻehaole, became more popular among Hawaii's ali'i. Soon, examples of this spectacular lei could only be found in museums. An influx of Christian missionaries frowned upon anything connected to Hawaiian religion, including the rituals associated with hula.
Their dresses were a beautiful yellow cloth, with wreaths of evergreen and wild flowers on their heads and necks, ornaments of ivory on their wrists. The motions of the dance were slow and graceful. The chiefs, seated in front, were so intent on the exhibition that we scarce expected to gain their attention.
In Native Hawaiian culture, feather lei were reserved only for female ali'i. The kiamanu, or birdcatcher, would travel into the forest to gather a few precious feathers. These were then painstakingly woven into stunning adornments, a Hawaiian form of fine art.
Women of high rank decorate their hair with wreaths made of yellow, red, and black feathers interwoven very skillfully. Necklaces are also made of numerous tiny braided strands of hair that support, as a rule, some pendant of coarsely carved whale tooth.
This was our jewelry. We didn't have the gold jewelry. We didn't have the pearls, the diamonds, the emeralds. So we used, in old Hawaii, this was their adornment. This was their jewelry.
Because of its permanent nature, Lei Hulumanu could be passed on from mother to daughter. To hold a feather lei is to hold a memory of someone dear.
She may have worn it for years as a Ka'ahumanu member or Hale o Nali'i or Daughters of Hawaii or any Hawaiian organization which is wore these leis as a symbol of their identity, their uniform, their respect to their ancestors. And so for you to have one given to you by a loved one like that is very precious.
Paulette learned the art of Lei Hulumanu from her mother, Mary Louise Kaleonahenahe Kekuewa. At their Kapahulu shop, many examples of their family's featherwork are displayed.
These are my dad's parents. The other lei I'd like to share with you is this pheasant lei and hat that were worn by my grandfather, my mother's father, who was a graduate of Kamehameha School 1917.
Sometimes a lei will end and an era will pass. In 1893, the Hawaiian kingdom was no more.
Last Saturday, the Hawaiians came out to see me. There were several hundred, and by 6 o'clock, I didn't know what to do with myself, I was so tired. It made me so sad to see so many of the Hawaiians looking so poor. In the old days, I am sure there were not so many people almost destitute.
A beautiful princess, living among her beloved peacocks at Ainahau, her family's home in Waikiki. Kaʻiulani was to be the next ruling ali'i of Hawaii, the next flower in our lei of royal blossoms. Because she favored the sweet scent of jasmine flowers growing at Ainahau, they were named Pikake, after her pet peacocks.
Kale means sweetheart. It also means the lei, but it also means sweetheart. And I felt that Kaʻiulani was the sweetheart of the Hawaiian Islands.
Performed by the junior girls, Lei no Kaʻiulani speaks of white lehua entwined with strands of maile. The lei spreads like a rainbow over the sea.
This is a song telling of how much the people loved her and all that she gave to them. A lot of them have their own feelings about Kaʻiulani, as I do. When they heard that we were singing about Kaʻiulani, a lot of them commented that, oh, they just love the princess.
The end of the Hawaiian monarchy is here at Mauna Ala. Kaʻiulani, Kalākaua, and Liliʻuokalani. Lydia Namahana Maioho is a descendant of a long line of kahu, guardians of the royal bones.
It started with our family hiding the bones of Kamehameha the Great. Now really the responsibility here is really a very heavy burden, because you're trusted to take care of them, to see that no, you know, desecration or vandalism, and that when people come in, they do respect the area, because Mauna Ala was blessed to be hallowed and sacred grounds.
Namahana's mother, Emily Taylor, was also a caretaker at Mauna Ala. Her song, Kuʻuleia Vapuhi, has been a favorite for generations. When it was chosen for the freshman class, Manu Boyd asked to do the musical arrangement.
Kuʻuleia Vapuhi was one of them. And I said, hands down, that's the song that I really want, because I love the song. It's a song that is filled with many memories for many people because of its longevity.
Also, Manu felt a closeness to the song because of his aloha for Namahana Maioho.
I have a chance to get to know her as a lei of her mother. I never had a chance to meet Mrs. Taylor, and in wanting to find out a little bit about the composer and the background of the song, I then went to the lei of the composer, in this case, Auntie Namahana.
Manu Boyd met with the freshman class to share his thoughts on Kuʻuleia Vapuhi. Song director Aaron Akamu was surprised to discover that he is a relative of the composer, Emily Taylor.
He talked about the translation and the girls echoing or answering the guy's call, and he went through how the song is sung and what the song talks about.
There is something special about how the song was put together, something that's indescribable, so that somebody who has no idea of what Hawaiian language or Hawaiian poetry is all about will find beauty and interest in Kuʻuleia Vapuhi, and somebody who's very involved in Hawaiian poetry and Hawaiian language will find other kinds of beauty in there too.
The Avapuhi is the ginger, so he's showing like the lover said his lost love was like the ginger, like he was trying to search for her, and he compared her to the ginger, which is, you know, a sweet smelling flower.
Everybody that comes to Mauna Ala, they're bringing me a ginger lei, and you know, this is in memory of your mama, you know, and I thank them very much.
When making a lei, an important concept is lokahi, or harmony. One's feelings will affect the outcome. In music, a unified approach and understanding of the song makes all the difference.
It talks about companionship within the forest. It talks about, you know, sort of a friendship between nature, you know, nature and its various aspects. So that could be, you know, like sort of allusion to, you know, how family works together, how friends work together.
Aaron feels that it is essential for the senior class to understand both the literal and poetic meanings of Sweet Lay Mama.
If they just start a rehearsal with nothing, then they come in not knowing what they really want. They come in, you know, just coming in to sing. But if they come in and they understand both meanings, it's like, oh, now I know what I'm singing about. Now I can, you know, I can put my heart, I can put my mana into it.
Many times, a song will describe a loved one by comparing that person to a lei or a flower. The sophomore boys are performing a composition by Charles E. King.
If the count of the flower is a person, it's really deep, you know what I mean, that relationship. So if you take Leilo Kelani, it really speaks of this beautiful woman, this lei, and her beauty is never fading.
A delicate pink rose growing on Maui. For these young men, it is a challenge to understand the song's softer emotions.
I think it's getting better though, because a lot of people are learning the Hawaiian language, so when they read it, they go, wow, you know what this song is really talking about? And they become interested. And I think by telling them the deeper meaning, they become very, very deep into the song, very interested.
Even a song itself can be a lei. Its words strung together by a skilled hakumen.
So like, this person who is going to haku the lei is weaving the best and the most beautiful blossoms into this lei. I must choose the best, the most colorful words, the words with the most deepest meanings. And I weave my lei with words. That becomes the mele. And in the last verse of Poliahu, it says, Hele koaloha no kuukina, pilipoli hemo'ole, nana kawakau. That your love is like a lei on my body that I wear close to my heart, never to be removed, never.
I think when you give a lei to someone, it's a very, very special occasion. It might be a birthday, it might be, you know, just because they're thinking of you and because they love you and they thought they'd mark this occasion with a lei. You know, and if you think of your life as a lei, then this is another beautiful experience. Another flower in your lei.
Back to the Blaisdell Arena. I'm Alicia Dow, and with me is Wayne Chang.
And as Holoua Stender just said, this should be a song contest to remember. It looks like the classes are all seated and ready to begin.
For 1994, the women of Kamehameha begin the show. The order of performance by each class within a category is determined by a drawing, and the freshman class will compete only in the combined class competition. And as each song leader steps up to the podium, we will hear their thoughts on song contest as they prepare their class to sing. So Wayne, going into this Who do you think are the favorites?
Well, Alisa, obviously the favorites are going to be the ones who won last year because they're all back here in competition. Last year there was a tremendous upset, as upsets go, because the sophomore women won last year. And they return as juniors. And the junior class, which are now seniors, won the men's division and they won the co-ed division. So, you know, once you've tasted that win, you know, it's theirs. They're hungry for that same feeling again. And I know that these classes have worked very hard.
No longer just automatic then that the senior class is going to make a clean sweep of all these awards tonight.
Not at all. Not at all. Okay, we are ready to begin. But we first have another thing about the class songs. Okay, this year you know it's Calais.
Right.
And you know that each of the classes must pick that song about Calais.
How do they do that? How do they choose their songs?
The songs are chosen because the teachers, we have a committee that comes together. They form the theme. Once that theme is set, then the music staff finds about 20 or 30 songs that fit that theme. Then the students themselves can pick which song they want. They pick a number, so they have first choice, second choice, or third choice. Sometimes there aren't many songs, so they just put the songs in a bowl, and that's what they choose. And they have to be with that song. They have to find the arranger, and this is what happens. Song contest happens.
This is a trivia question, okay? What was your class song in your sophomore year?
My sophomore year, we had the men's division. We sang this song called Ho'oheno Ikumaka.
Hum a few bars?
Oh, with another song. I can't remember. Jeez. Alisa, that was a long time ago.
Okay.
This is 72. I think that was back 31 or something. It's a long, long time.
Okay. How about senior year?
Senior year. Easy. Kavohi Kukapulani in a medley with Hanale Bay. And we won. We won. Seniors in class of 1969. And it was led by Jonathan Osorio.
Ah, he's here tonight.
Yes, we just saw Jonathan. And but we were one of those classes where every year we had a different leader. That tells you much about our class, see? Most of the classes, once they pick a leader their freshman and sophomore year, they stay with that leader. Usually, yes. And especially if they've won, they stay with that leader.
Do you have a favorite? You've been here and you've been at the rehearsals and stuff. I don't know, is that a fair question to ask you?
Not yet, because, Alisa, you know, we were here on Thursday when the classes practiced. We did get to hear some of the practice in the exhibition hall. What happens at practice does not necessarily mean that is what's going to happen tonight.
Very true.
And it could be many things that happen, good and bad. The example is if a leader gets up and they give the pitches, and I hope that happens in no class, but if they give a pitch and it's the wrong pitch,
everything goes down.
Everything, if they don't stop and have the sense and presence to stop and repitch, they may start their entire song contest song wrong.
What's happening with the kids now as they're sitting here? I mean, is this whole thing just kind of a big blur for them? Do they have butterflies? Or what are they feeling?
I think that the kids who are right now, if you look at them, they're just so calm. I don't know why they are. I think the parents and the grandparents who are here probably have more butterflies than the students. They really are calm, and the students from yesterday just showed what they were made of. They came in, they did their business, they did it well, they moved off, they came back in tonight. Like, this is just second hat to most of them. If anyone is upset and has the butterflies, it's the freshmen. So you watch the ones in red. It's their first time.
They're so cute.
Yeah, they are. They really are.
Well?
I know the seniors are just going to be seated right now. There's the announcement.
1994.
We begin with the Oli, performed by Junior Kahikina da Silva, daughter of Kihei and Mapuana da Silva of Kailua.
As the daughter of a kumuhula and a Hawaiian scholar, she spent her life immersed in Hawaiian culture.
Kai ho atu ye ye ye
Offering tonight's pule is Senior Monty McCumber of Ka'u.
Monty is the son of Monty and Helen McCumber.
Please rise for the pule. E pule kako. E ko mako mako iloko kolani. Ke mahalo aku nei mā kō ia oe e kia kua. I keia ahi ahi kūi ka wā. I nā haumana a pau o ki kula ki e ke e o kamehameha. Ame nā poe i hele mai ani i. O keia ka aha o o kūkū mele. Kana hitu kumalua. E olu olu oe ka makua lani. E ho mai ka ia mā kō pākahi. O ia hoi ka pohe i ho olohi nei me ka poe. E himini nei, e ho o i kaika i nā alakai, me nā hauman a pau o kēla me keia papa, i kō la kō himini ana, i nā mele o nā leu i o Hawaii nei. Mā kaino o kau keki hiva hiva o Yesu Kristo. Āmene.
Leading the gathering in Sons of Hawaii is Keoni Naipo of Hilo, son of Calvin Naipo Jr. and Devan Naipo. Keoni has been active in the symphonic band, concert glee, and Bishop Memorial Choir, and has attended Kamehameha since the ninth grade.
And together and in hand.
for the Ho'okipa Mai, welcoming our special guests, is Haku Applegate.
Mai kale lehua o Hawaii kua uli. Ikalei pu pu ni ihau o ka hele lani. Aloha ahi ahi kakou. Welcome to the 72nd Annual Kamehameha Schools Song Contest. This evening, we are fortunate to have with us our distinguished guests. As I present them to you, please hold your applause until all have been introduced. Governor John Waihe'e and his wife, Lynn Waihe'e. The trustees of the Kamehameha Schools, Bernice Pauwehi Bishop Estate. Chair, Mr. Myron Thompson, his granddaughter Tia, and his grandson Naya. First Vice Chair, Mr. Oswald Stender and his wife Ku'ule Stender. Second Vice Chair, Mr. Richard Wong and his wife Marie Wong. Secretary, Mrs. Lokelani Lindsay and her husband, Steve Lindsay. Treasurer, Mr. Henry Peters and his daughter, Kim. We are also pleased to have with us this evening the president of the Kamehameha Schools, Dr. Michael J. Chun, and his wife, Bina Chun. The principal of the Kamehameha Secondary School, Mr. Anthony Ramos and his wife, Suzanne Ramos. This year, we celebrate Kalei, the garland which we adorn ourselves and loved ones as a gesture of aloha. Tonight, the sons and daughters of Kamehameha shall be Kalei, as we adorn and pay tribute to the spirit of our benefactress, the beloved Ali'i Wahine, Bernice Pauwehi Bishop. This evening, we will sing our songs of the many beautiful lays and loves of Hawaii and her people. So please prepare yourself for the voices of the sons of the sky and the daughters of the earth as we present for your enjoyment, Kalei.
Introducing the judges for this evening's contest is Senior Miley Brown of Kahala. Her parents are Alan and Martha Brown.
This evening, five musical experts have been chosen to determine which classes will drink the sweet nectar of victory. I have the honor of introducing tonight's judges. Please hold your applause until all have been introduced. Judges, will you please stand as you are presented? There are two choral judges, Miss Nola Nahulu, a 1971 Kamehameha graduate, is currently with the University Laboratory School. She holds a Master of Arts from the University of Hawaii at Mauna. Mr. Scott Speck, a former Fulbright scholar, is associate conductor of the Honolulu Symphony and has conducted orchestras throughout the world. He received his bachelor's degree from Yale University. We have two language judges, Mr. Moses Crabb, a 1977 Kamehameha graduate, is a teacher in the Hawaiian Language Immersion Program at Pūhala Elementary School. He holds a bachelor's degree from the University of Hawaii at Mauna. Ms. Pualani Kanahele is the holder of the National Heritage Fellowship Award from the National Endowment for the Arts. She received her bachelor's degree from the University of Hawaii at Hilo. The overall judge is Mr. Randy Fong, a 1978 Kamehameha graduate. Currently on sabbatical leave from Kamehameha, he is a composer, choral arranger, choreographer, and Hawaiian language speaker. Mr. Fong is a master's degree candidate at the University of Hawaii at Manoa. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the judges for this special night.
In 1994, the women begin the contest. Senior Ryan Oda, son of Bob and Tara Oda of Hawaii Kai, introduces the women's competition.
Nani Hawaii ina le a ala o nauna. The beauty of Hawaiian women has often been compared to the appearance and scent of a lei. This evening, the women of Kamehameha will sing of maile, carnation, pikake, ilima, and lehua leis, showing off their own special beauty in hopes of capturing the New England Mother's Cup. May I have the order, please? Tonight's competition will begin with the senior women, followed by the junior women, and finally the sophomore women. Ladies and gentlemen, Napua le ui o Kamehameha.
Sarah Gomes introduces the senior women. She's the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Timothy Gomes of Pauilo.
Aloha mai e na mamo kili lehu. The fragrant pikake and its companion, the ilima, form a lei whose love comes with intense desire in the uplands, where it is cherished in the cool Kalahala rain. Tonight, the women of the class of 1994 will shower their voices upon you, like the rain that showers the pikake lei. Like the unique fragrance of the pikake, the voices of the senior women will sing Charles E. King's Ku'ulei Pikake. Ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Feilin Ku'ule Aloha Paishan, I present to you Nawahine o ka papa umi kumalua.
It's been a challenge because coming in at new, it's made me work harder. I used to be afraid to be in front of the class and to give out my opinion, but now, you know, I have more confidence in myself.
Ah.
did a beautiful job of that late percussion, and you can just tell that they have the understanding of the words and just gave it their all, Lisa.
Beautiful, beautiful rendition. They've come a long way since rehearsal.
This is Kavena Suganuma as she introduces the junior women. She's the daughter of Leighton La'akea and Leimomi Suganuma of Honolulu.
O ua mau pua lehua I vili ia me maile lauli'i. Leis of lehua blossoms entwined with strands of maile refer to the elegance of Princess Ka'iulani in the junior women's song, Lei no Ka'iulani. Just as John Edwards gave this song as a gift to her, the women of the class of 1995, led by Hilary Meyer, present their lei to the people of Hawaii. E ola mau e ka iu o nā lani, a mena kini lehu lehu o ia aina nei o Hawaii.
Hilary Meyer, the junior women's leader, uses visualization as a tool to perfect her conducting.
I imagine myself in front of the girls directing them, and it helps me because I gain more confidence, and I know I'm better prepared.
Hilary led her women to a stunning upset win in her first year of competition.
They came prepared. They did a beautiful job with Lena Kaiulani.
Would that be a real stunner if they did it again this year?
Listen, a dynasty has happened in the past from, you know, 4 years in a row, 3 years in a row. Hopefully it happens again. Introducing the sophomore women is Dion Ululani Kabalsi, the daughter of Liberta Lee and John Kabalsi.
Anoai kako e na ho aloha. Tonight, Pierre Kona'i Aupuni will lead the sophomore women in the mele, Lei Poni Mo'i. This mele, composed by Charles E. King, speaks of the love a man has for a woman and how the vibrant characteristics of the Poni Mo'i, or carnation blossoms, unite them in thought and feeling.
reminisce, and imagine as the sophomore women discover their rendezvous. E ho'i mo'i ko'ua e pili.
First year song leader Tierra Kana'i'aupuni is a little apprehensive tonight.
This is my first year directing, so I'm a little nervous. And my class, they're just getting into singing in different parts and having so little of a time to get two songs down.
She is from Kamawela and is the daughter of Mrs. Shannon Avero and Philip Murray.
They did the best they could, and you know, they're hoping to redo the same thing that the sophomores did last year. The strong voices of the men of Kamehameha are introduced by Jackie Ng. She's the daughter of Peter and Doris Ng.
The men of Kamehameha could be described as ha'ahil, proud, and pukonakona, strong, as the great and noble ancestors of ancient Hawaii. Tonight, the men will compete for the George Allenton Andrus Cup. But, as we all know, only one class will be victorious. Who will be the triumphant group? Will it be the sophomore men, the junior men, or perhaps the senior men in their final competition? May I have the order, please? Having the privilege of singing first, we'll go to the senior man. Next, we'll hear from the junior men. And singing third will be the voices of the sophomore men. Aia na ko, o Kamehameha.
Brian Kovaloff, senior class treasurer, presents the senior men.
The son of Thomas and Darlene Kovaloff, Brian is the varsity tennis team captain.
Me o ko kavelina o ke aloha. The liko lehua stands bold in its representation of a love so overpowering that nothing can dispel it. In this song, the desire for a sweetheart who wears the bronzy red leaf buds of lehua combines with the lovely fragrance of lihu'e. Under the direction of Monty McComber II, the senior men will also stand bold as we sing this Charles E. King classic, Le Liko Le Hua. Ah, ike ia manava, ia no na manu vivo ole. O ka papa umi kumalua.
Monty McComber knows the high that comes when you sing with understanding.
My song is this lovemaking, which is brought out through words. It's once they learn the meaning, and once they learn how the words are expressed, and then it's just this wonderful feeling.
The voices are mature. It was really good. They did a nice job. Thank you, seniors.
Introducing the junior men is Kekuni Agard, the son of Louis and Carol Agard. He is the student council parliamentarian.
Na'ue ke aloha e kuia lava. You are mine, my love. Declares a lover to his sweetheart in Lei Avapuhi by Mekia Kialaka'i. This love song tells of the sweet-smelling ginger of Hawaii, with its unforgettable fragrance and its delicate blossoms which bloom in a sacred place. Lana malie ihoho'i kamana'o. Ladies and gentlemen, Ian Chun and the Junior Men.
Ian Chun can still remember the moment he realized he had to be a song leader.
I can't remember what class. I think it was the senior class of that year. And it was the men's director. And it just, when he started to direct, it just got to me. It's like, wow, I want to do that. I really do.
They know this song, and it means all the world to just cling to a song this beautiful, and the class did a beautiful job with it too. Presenting the sophomore men is Jason Kaniakua, son of Mr. and Mrs. Mark Kaniakua of Mililani.
Aloha kako e na ohana a me na hoaloha o kamehameha. Tonight, the sophomore men, under the direction of Ka'imi Pele Kai, will sing to capture the ho'okūkū mele no nā kane o ka mehameha. Written and composed by Charles E. King, our song describes the island of Maui, the home of a flower whose charming petals and sweet fragrance create a precious and beloved lei, a heavenly lei of Loke Lani, Maui's special rose. Listen now as the men of the class of 1996 take you to the island of Maui as we present to you Lei Loke Lani.
Ka'imi Pele Kai, the son of Henry and Merlin Pele Kai, has watched his class grow in their musical ability.
When you teach the kids the song, they learn the notes. And it's when they get the song and they feel the song and they sing it with understanding from their heart, it's a high point.
Oh, my.
Well, sophomores, welcome to Song Contest. Your first effort, not a bad job.
That young man is a phenomenal song leader. I hope we see more of him.
Sure is. Freshman Kamani Kualaau, son of Mr. and Mrs. Ronald Kualaau, presents the co-ed competition.
Tonight, for the first time, the class of 1997 will be joining Kamehameha's co-ed competition. The freshmen, under the direction of Aaron Akamu, will be singing Ku'ulei of Apuhi, a song that describes a man's search for his lei of Apuhi, his love. The sophomore class is performing Lei Loke o Kavika. Directed by Kamalani Wilson, they speak of Kavika Kawanana Kua's Lei of Roses. Ian Costino will be leading the juniors in Ku'ulei Mokihana, which tells of the soft permeating fragrance of the Lawa'e and Mokihana. Finally tonight, the seniors, led by Aaron Salah, will present Sweet Lei Mamo, a melody about the sweet safflower garland. May I have the order, please? Thank you. The sophomore class will be singing Last for You Tonight. Third will be the seniors. The junior class will be second, and starting it all for you this evening will be the freshmen. Ladies and gentlemen, the men and women of Kamehameha, Napua Powahi.
Freshman leader Aaron Akamu, the son of Peyton and Pua Akamu, told us that his class is upbeat about their odds.
With freshmen, the attitude is we aren't definitely going to win, but we do have a chance, and then they really try to make that chance come through.
Yeah.
relatively well for their first year in competition.
You know, Lisa, the last time a freshman class won was in 1975. And that was the first and last time a freshman class has won. And if anything, this class is first in the hearts of a lot of people here. They did a wonderful job. They like their song. They seem to love their leader. Rapport is there. And I wish every freshman class came in with such a bang into the song contest.
Wonderful enthusiasm on their part.
Junior co-ed leader Ian Castino has watched his class mature with experience.
They've matured. It's matured into more of a, we've done this before and we know what to expect and we can improve upon what we did the year before.
Ian is the son of Victoria Castino of Kapa'a, Kauai.
Craftsman in what he does, he had direct control over the entire song contest for his class, and they did a fabulous job. It was a difficult arrangement. First-time song director Aaron Salah has an unusual musical taste, but he doesn't see it as incompatible with the song contest.
I like opera, and I like Hawaiian music, and they come together in the sense that they both have this foundation of love. The difference is that in opera, a man sings directly to a woman, whereas in Hawaiian music, a man sings about a woman.
Aaron is the drum major of the marching band and student director of the Concert Glee Club.
Thank you.
By Robert Casimiro was a winner, and they did a fine job. Again, thank you, seniors, for making this night so enjoyable for all of us.
Mr. and Mrs. Nathan Wilson will be watching their sophomore son, Kamalani, lead his class tonight. He had a solid strategy for his young class.
I try to make them have fun, like to make them relax, but at the same time get the music across.
This is Kamalani's second year as a co-ed leader.
Oh, God.
Freshman, but tough choice.
You know, the heart says freshman, but the seniors did an excellent job. You know, this sophomore class, we talked about what we did when we were in school. I thought it was our sophomore class, and remembering now, this song, Leilokio Kaviko, is sung by our junior girls, but it always brought back painful memories because we really didn't do a good job back then. Not like how they are doing now. The sophomores did a fine, fine job.
Judges have their work cut out for them on this.
Yeah. Keikoa Kaluhiwa decided his involvement in other school activities would keep him from leading his class this year, but he's not stressed by his busy schedule.
I look at it as a motivation in life, a challenge, not so much stress, but challenge in life, whereas it gives me direction and a goal and purpose in life.
Thank you.
flowing. What do you think about this competition?
Well, I think that I'm glad we're not judges, number one. You know, hearing the competition through headsets, part live, part our heart, hearing with our heart and our na'al rather than a good ear. I really don't know who's going to win this competition.
Let's go class by class. The women's competition, what do you think? Hillary Meyer did an outstanding job tonight.
She did. Hillary Meyer did. The women's competition may be very tight, and I think it's going to be, here's my prediction, between the seniors and the juniors.
Toss up between the seniors
and the juniors? Toss up. Both did a very fine job with their...
Again, Hillary Meyer took her class to an upset last year.
That's right, and she came back with a force and a vengeance this year that I think may pay off in the total points that are being given by the judges.
Who, your favorite in the men's competition?
Gosh, the men's competition, I really enjoyed the junior men, and they loved their song, and it showed in how they sang. The senior men did a fine job, they have the maturity, and the sophomores, well, this is their first year, and they need to grow a little bit vocally, they really do. But that's the nature of most sophomore competitions.
The combined competition, I have to say that the freshmen, music notwithstanding, just from projection personality, the freshmen did a wonderful job this evening. They sang well too, but just their whole presentation was really, really well done.
I agree with you. It was like a killer. It went right to your heart and pulled it out when the freshman men in their song turned and faced the women of their class. Those things mean something, and the song written by Emily Taylor is like the old melody of Nohili. It's Leavapuhi. It's just a beautiful Leavapuhi. It's a beautiful, beautiful song, and the freshmen did a fine job with it.
And as the scores are being added up, it's time for what has become an important part of each song contest.
This is the part of the program that everyone is anxious to see. The competition is over, and everyone here can simply enjoy the ho'ike, an exhibition of mele and hula, tonight echoing our theme, Kalei.
I'm looking at some old pictures, people that I miss.
Who is that, Tutu?
That is my grandmother. She was such a beautiful person and a wonderful person. And we would sit together. She would tell me many stories about our families and about Hawaii Lei, how it used to be.
Like a lei, linking us to the distant past, our shared stories and experiences bring us closer to Hawaii of yesteryear.
On any Saturday afternoon in Honolulu, the girls, cantering up and down the streets on horseback, put on all the finery they can scare up. Fine black silk robes, flowing red ones that nearly put your eyes out. Others as white as snow. Still others that discount the rainbow. And they trim their jaunty hats with fresh flowers and encircle their dusky throats with homemade necklaces of the brilliant vermilion-tinted blossoms of the ohia.
It was a time when Waikiki was considered a rural town, when Hawaii was still a kingdom. Both commoners and monarchs favored the finely crafted shell lei of Niihau. While on Kauai in 1871, Queen Emma wrote to a friend, "Enclosed is a small necklace of shells, the latest novelty in that ornament from Niihau. I have only just got two strings of them. I'm glad you liked your necklace. It is a pretty improvement on the plain kind." The art of Leipupu or Niihau has changed little since traditional times. Families still gather on Niihau's beaches in search of the exquisite shells.
An early morning walk to the beach where you could gather the shells. And
sometimes while we're picking them, we'll just race with the tides. Like the olelo no ea uhana kalima nana kamaka pa'akawaha. Your hands are busy, and yet at the same time we're sharing stories about the day's event, about our livelihoods, and it keeps us busy. The hands are working at the same time.
A typical scene for making shale is a relative's home. More stories are exchanged and laughter is often heard. It is thought that the mood of the maker will determine how the lei looks.
When you look at a ni'ihau lei, you know that it is closely identified with ni'ihau, because it's only found there. When you receive a ni'ihau lei, then you know that you have gotten one of the oldest still alive traditional works of art.
This is my father's hat. He loved horses. He was a cowboy on the island of Hawaii.
Wow. I wish I could have known him.
Well, actually you do. He lives on in all of us, especially in the stories he used to tell about his Paniola life.
The Hawaiian cowboy cut a dashing figure, riding hard and working hard. But at the day's end in the high country, he was known to gather maile and akulikuli, sometimes at full gallop. On the ride home, he would weave a lei for his sweetheart.
Honolulu civilization, which, if not very distinguished, is certainly very elaborate. When your ship leaves Honolulu, they hang leis around your neck, garlands of sweet-smelling flowers. The wharf is crowded and the band plays a melting Hawaiian tune. The people on board throw colored streamers to those standing below. When the ship moves slowly away, the streamers break softly, and it's like the breaking of human ties.
Many still remember the festive atmosphere of boat day, the air alive with the scent of newly sown lei.
And at the top of 4th and King Street, we would put our wares on the ground, and then we would take it and put it in our arms. And as the people walked down, and not only us, but the whole street was lined with lei sellers. No, they were more excited. Like, they liked the colors, you know. It was a happy thing because they had the band there, you know, playing, and everything was so colorful.
Not far from Honolulu Harbor, Sweetheart still sells her lei. But now, her lei of 5 children and their 5 spouses all kokua to the family business.
This is on the busy days when they come down, like graduation and Mother's Day and song contest. Some of them take off from work sometimes and they come. I'm just blessed with children who just want to help mom and dad.
Is that you, Tutu? You're so pretty.
That's when I used to entertain at Waikiki. And this is the ukulele that I used to play with.
It must have been so much fun.
It was. I had a good time. And that's when I met your grandfather. He brought me a sweet ginger lei, and I can still smell it now. And he was so handsome.
In Waikiki, tourism had become big business, and floral lei were in demand. The popular flowers were brightly colored and aromatic. Designs were created to please the customer. But today, many lei makers are returning to their roots and rediscovering the traditions of Hawaiian lei making.
There's different plants for different gods and goddesses, because that they're their kinolau, their body forms of that god or goddess.
Careful attention is paid to which plants are woven together. And there is a growing awareness of the spirit of giving and wearing a lei.
In the past, when you were coming down from volcano or something, you would stop along the way to rest and you would make a lei, just in case you came upon somebody that invited you into their house and gave you food or whatever, you would give them that lei.
When you see ni'ihau shells, it reminds you even more about not only the rarity of the shell, but also the specialness of people that may have worn that lei. When you see the yellow mamo feathers, you think, of course, of your tutu who might have worn that lei, or of a parade of ka'ahumanu women so dignified and stately. And so we wanted to portray that in Ho'ike, all these memories of life.
Ho'ike will be beginning in just a few minutes. The people who have worked very hard on Ho'ike will give them the credit now, because it has been a long task to get this done. Holo'ua Stender, acting director of the Music Department Performing Arts. Randy Fong called back out of sabbatical to help with the dancing musical arrangement and overall theme concept.
You played a big part.
Oh, I was a part of it too. I was teaching. I taught some numbers, and we worked Tuesdays and Thursday nights. Ipo Vaughn, another director, costuming, input, just a lot more people to mention. But it's ready. We're in black, and here we go. Ho'ike.
Oka ohana. Ku'ulei aloha. My family is a lei of love. That's true, you know. I've been making leis for as long as I can remember. My tutu taught me when I was young. I remember going up into the mountains early in the morning before the sun rose. What an adventure! Tutu was so particular. One basket for lehua, and the other for maile, each sprig chosen for its perfect shape and beauty. As I got older and started creating my own lei, I came to appreciate the work and preparation involved in lei making. Truly, it is a labor of love. It's no wonder the word lei also refers to people that we hold so dear. Our beloved Keiki, our cherished Kupuna, even the gods themselves.
Kelei mai lau kaulai ke kai e, ke mal mal maon I hau ua mali e, a mali e pa ka inu aila.
tu mai la na lo na we ke kai no na we ka la no pna ka vai nei no ka lu an no i kla we a
As a young girl, that all things found in nature could be fashioned into lei. One of my fondest memories is of my own tutu draped with lei pupu. I would marvel at the tiny, tiny shells and how it would take thousands to fashion these rare lei. As a distinguished member of the Ka'ahumanu Society, another of Tutu's prized possessions was her yellow feather lei. Showing prominently against her black holoku, her lei was worn with great pride and dignity, and truly reflected the spirit of that noble queen for whom the society was named, Eola Kainoa o Ka'ahumanu.
Thank you.
Gardenia. Each flower has a personality all its own. They are just like people. Often, they will remind me of someone special in my life. It's no wonder that they have inspired people to write some of the most beautiful and unforgettable songs.
Aloha.
Thank you.
precious hours, enchanting moments with you, make me love you. Kulei avokuhi melekele, ipuhi ja ike ala onalna, ohi ikamana oja oe, kulei avokuhi. You're as lovely as can be, my yellow gentle lay. My heart is yearning for you, my amapuni. Ai na I amai, anakabuana. Kuulei avokuhi melele, ohe no ikakuhai.
Oh, yeah. I have woven into it the love of our kupuna, and now I pass it on to you. Wear it proudly, and someday you will have the joy of passing it on to your mo'opuna. Aloha. Wear now your lei through the summers and winters, for this lei of love is forever.
On what I thought was another wonderful ho'ike.
I think the students have done it again. They've pulled off another beautiful song contest with their singing as well as their beautiful dancing and their participation in ho'ike. All of this hard work has paid off.
Well, one of the nice things about ho'ike is that we're able to express ourselves and express the Hawaiian spirit. And with kalei and the value of family, and the right songs that are dear to people's hearts. Some of these bring back memories like the Hawaiian Cowboy and Uncle Saul Bright. I mean, he's gone, he's left us, but what a wonderful man and entertainer he was. And of course the last song, Na Pua, Pua Ka'i Lima, written by Auntie Kau'i Zudemeister. I want to thank especially the family of Auntie Kau'i Zudemeister for having the ability and the love to share her with the rest of the world. And truly it was the world. And we do miss her. And that particular song was just our little way of saying thank you, Auntie Kau'i, and we'll remember you always.
Robin, can you tell us a little bit more about that, the background of that last hula?
Pua Ka'i Lima? Well, I believe Auntie Kau'i wrote it for her family. And in that song mentions the chief Kakuhihewa, who was a ruling chief of the island of Oahu. So Auntie Kau'i's mana'o and part of herself and a legacy that she leaves behind for her family was written into that song.
Beautiful, beautiful young woman dancing that hula.
Yeah. You know, again, with Auntie Kau'i, we used even in the script where the last thing that our narrator says is, my lei is now complete. That really came from Auntie Kau'i. And this was, you know, toward the last really minutes of her life when she talked about, you know, my lei began and now my lei is ended. And it is complete. My life is complete as all of us. I mean, this is the lesson for all of us here in Hawaii. As we were born, our lei, the first part of our lei begins. We complete it at the end of our lives. And what lei we have and we take with us is also a lei that we leave with others, because each one of those pieces of that lei is someone in our lives, someone a family member, a child, a grandchild. And we leave little lit flowers in everybody else's leis in our life. And this is one of the things that Hawaiians understood so well. And, you know, and I know others know the same thing, but...
Always amazing how every year the caliber of the performance and the quality of ho'ike is so high. It just never ceases to amaze me.
Okay, Leslie Williams, the daughter of Bertina Au and Fred Williams, is a student body director of external affairs.
It's about that time we've all been waiting for. Though most people believe the toughest part of the competition has been completed, to these 1,734 students, this very moment is the most nervous, traumatic, stressful, anxious moment of all. All right, I'll stop stalling. The first award is given to the student director who portrays the highest qualities of leadership. He or she is chosen on the following criteria: best organization, most dedication throughout rehearsals, and of course, leadership. Mrs. Calvin McGregor will announce this year's recipient of the Louise O'Oy McGregor Award.
On behalf of my family, it gives me great pleasure to present the Louise O'Oy McGregor Award to Aaron Solar.
So I was able to sit in some of Aaron's rehearsals, and he is a fantastic leader. Very calm, cool, organized young man. He's going to go a long way.
This was his first year as song leader.
And you know, this represents his ability to get his class ready and in shape for this competition. That's what this award is all about.
Isn't he also the drum major for the Warrior Marching Band?
He sure is.
He's a terrific guy.
The next award, presented by Mr. Eli Nahulu, is the Helen Deshay Beamer Award. It was initially added to the competition in 1993 and honors Mrs. Beamer's vast contributions, shaping Hawaiian music into what it is today. This award recognizes the best musical presentation by a group.
With the possibility of 108 points, the winner with 102 points goes to the men of the junior class.
The musicality meaning that the choral arrangement, their rendition of that arrangement, was what impressed the judges the most. 102 out of 108 possible points for junior men. This is the Helen Deshay Beamer Award. It's a wonderful accomplishment also, juniors.
Is this a sign of what's to come in the next few minutes? Will we see the junior men accepting another trophy?
I don't know. Let's see.
It's getting exciting.
The following instills in all the students at Kamehameha, Kamana o Ka'o Lalo Hawaii, the power of the Hawaiian language. This award, it goes to the group which has achieved superiority in the use of Hawaiian language in their song. The Olelo Makuahine Award, in honor of former trustee Mr. Richard Lyman Jr., will be presented by Dr. Michael Chun.
Before I make this award, I just want to thank these fine young men and women for a wonderful evening of entertainment. Papa Lyman would be very, very proud to present this trophy to the junior men.
Determine the winner.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
But the junior men sure have a lot to celebrate and be proud of because they work hard. They deserve these trophies.
And a lot of the credit goes to their leader, Ian. He's been absolutely great these past few days and weeks practicing and trying to get his class up to a level that they've come to so far.
Mr. Anthony Ramos will present the George Allenson Andrus Cup, which is awarded to the men who have presented a moving and effective piece in the opinion of the judges.
I'm very pleased to present the George Allenson Andrus Cup to the junior men.
Well, purple rule.
It just seems to be that color, that majestic color. For those who may be watching and wondering, it was determined after the junior men won both of the subcategories, they had to have won this award. Now, you know, this is a very odd year for this to happen. That's not a normal situation with so many classes competing, men, women, and co-ed. Any one of these songs could have won those separate trophies, but they have it, the Andrus Cup.
The next award honors the winner of the women's competition. Donated in 1922 by Mrs. E.G. Scoville, this award recognizes the women who have delighted us with their presentation. Mrs. Bina Chun will present the New England Mother's Cup.
Papa'umi Kumalua.
Well, the senior women did do an outstanding job this evening. I think they deserve that award that they've gotten.
This is really kind of an upset because the winners last year are the juniors, and look at them. They're standing up applauding the seniors. And for those of you who needed to translate, you know, our students learn Hawaiian quite fast here from Erin Hill. And she said, Papa'umi Kumalua, they all knew right away, the senior women. Congratulations, seniors.
The final award And now moving on to the next award, which is the final award, is awarded to the class which has successfully combined both men's and women's voices. Trustee Myron Thompson will end tonight's award ceremony by presenting the Charles E. King Cup.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in commending all of our young people for the beautiful performance tonight. And to you, our students, I'd like to express our special aloha for your dedication, your hard work, and for bringing pride to yourselves, your family, and to the ohana of the Kamehameha Schools. And now, I gotta find the paper. I know you will all join me in recognizing the recipient of the Charles E. King Award, the junior class.
They put the effort in too, and they deserve some of this credit, because without it there would be no competition at all. But genius, terrific.
How fitting that their leader, Ian Costino, is from the island of Kauai. He wears purple tonight, and his song, I believe, was Kuulei Mokihana, a Kauai song. So everything is what you would call pili, or all...
Everything lines up, you know, all the
everything
planets
lines
tonight,
up in your favor.
It was like that tonight for the junior. It was like that. Terrific. Again, our heartfelt condolences. Actually, our love goes to the freshman class. The co-ed freshman, yes, Elisa?
My sentimental favorite.
Well, I'd have to join you in that also.
However, you know, here we have Robin. I talked about the first class winning. The co-ed freshman was in 1975. You know, that's Robin Makua's class. And there's one thing she really doesn't want to see tarnished is that particular.
Definitely.
Oh, Robin.
Definitely.
They were wonderful, though. Freshman
love them dearly, but we would like to hold on to that record.
Keep that title of distinction. Right. But they all of the classes tonight did a wonderful job representing themselves and coming to their school.
This is the part now where they're getting together to sing the state anthem.
Oh,
The Kamehameha School 72nd Annual Song Contest was brought to you by